Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of the Indian Captains. My name is Shoaib and today I'm going to be continuing the last two videos. So if you haven't seen our last two videos, make sure to check that video before you check this video. So today's video, I'm going to be talking to you about medical assessments, certain terminologies that you need to know, special medicals, medically unfit, what you need to do, temporary unfit. So these are the topics that I'm going to be touching upon today, which will basically end our sessions on medical, TGCA medical class 1, class 2. So in the last two videos, we spoke about class 2 and class 1 medical, and we gave you a complete idea as to the cost and the test involved. So once all of that is done, and when you do your class 1 medical, it can be done only in 4 centers, which is 2 civil and 2 FO centers. So after that, you have to do something called as a renewal, class 1 renewal, which happens every 1 year. So when you're doing your class 1 renewals, it can be done in any class 1 DGCA empanel doctor. So they can do it can be a private doctor, or it can even be at an FO center. But when you are doing it with a FO center, which is mandatory if it comes under the special medical. A special medical is nothing but certain age, at certain age you need to do the medical at an FO center. It is mandatory. For example, at the age of 25, 30, 35, so on and so forth. After 40, they have certain tests that you need to perform every year. So I'll leave that picture in your screen right now, and also in the link below. So remember that at the specific age, you have to do certain number of tests for your renewal. And after 60, that you already know, you need to do your medicals every 6 months. And remember, all your special medicals have to be at an FO center, which is basically IIM Bangalore or Jorhat. So most likely these are the things that you need to keep in mind when you're doing your special medicals. Moving on from here, when your medicals are done, you get something called as a CA35 form from your doctor. That's nothing but a temporary license or a temporary medical certificate, which ensures that you're medically fit as on date. But it is mentioned in that your medicals are subject to verification by DGCA, and the final assessment will be generated. So you have a time of at least 3 months to complete or rather to use this CA35 form for your flight duties. So you are eligible for that. But after 3 months, you cannot continue with your flight duties until and unless you get your medical assessment. Your medical assessment is nothing but a small copy from DGCA, which confirms your medical license or medical certificate. And it has your date of test, validity, where you've done it, address, your personal details, your height, weight, so on and so forth. With that also comes two main headings called limitations and recommendations. So what are these? So if you are a person, for example, using corrective lenses for your vision, for example, spectacles or any contact lenses, it will be mentioned in the limitation that you need to carry 2 pairs of such spectacle or a contact lens for your flight duties. And all the details will be mentioned at limitations. What does that mean? That if you do not carry it, you cannot exercise the privilege of a class 1 medical. So keep that in mind, that your limitations, whatever is written, you need to follow that. And there can be various medical conditions which the doctor seems that it cannot be termed medically unfit, but if you use certain devices or objects, for example here a spectacle, you can keep that in mind. Second one is something called as a recommendation. So sometimes what happens is when you are doing your medicals, the doctor recommends you to get an opinion from another doctor regarding so and so. For example, an heart issue, your blood pressure, let's say cholesterol, or you know, various things like these where you need to get an opinion from another doctor. And also sometimes what happens is a doctor can declare you medically fit and write in the recommendation that you have been recommended to do certain tests in your next medical, irrespective if it's a special medical or not. All right, so that's also another recommendation. And of lately, we've also been hearing that many pilots are getting a recommendation that they need to do the medical every 3 months, every 6 months, which is I'm sure there would be a big medical issue that, you know, that's where that is mentioned. So that means you have to not renew it once a year. For that particular person, it has to be done every 3 months or 6 months, whatever is written in the recommendations. And for some, it's also said that you need to do your renewals at FO centers only. So that is another statement which you need to follow. So that's just a basic idea about your medical assessments. I've also touched upon special medicals, which I will leave it in the comments below. Moving forward from here, many pilots also sometimes face something called as a temporary unfit. Sometimes what happens is their weight is a little bit more, as in they are overweight, or sometimes they have certain issues which the doctor personally feels that no, at this point of time I can't issue a medically fit certificate. So what they do is they issue something called as a temporary unfit certificate, or a TMU, temporary medically unfit certificate. So what does that mean? So when that happens, sometimes they give you a time span to come back after correcting it. For example, if it's your weight, you know, you need to lose your weight and come back for your medical to complete that medical procedure. And sometimes what happens is they issue you a duration saying that for 4 weeks you're termed medically unfit or temporary unfit, and after that you need to do certain tests, get opinions from certain doctors, and go to an FO center or whatever mentioned in that medical form. I will give an example or a demo copy of a particular TMU sheet, which you will see on the screen. And it will be mentioned where you need to do your medical, so on and so forth, okay? So that's a temporary unfit. So that does not mean you're permanently unfit, but you got to be, you got to keep in mind that it's a very serious issue. Right, so whatever it is, make sure you get that thing rectified and get a medically fit certificate. And sometimes they also add that in a recommendation saying, you know, he or she has to lose some weight, so on and so forth. Moving on to something called as permanent unfit, PMU, permanently medically unfit. So what does this stand for? So if you have been declared permanently unfit by DGCA, it means that you have lost your privileges to fly, or you know, use your privileges as a pilot, and that is basically ending your career. So many people have got that from DGCA, and you are allowed to contest it and, you know, show necessary proofs, go on medicals again with certain doctors, so on and so forth. Usually all the temporary unfits, the special medicals, and your medically permanently unfit, mostly these medicals happen only at FO centers. So once you have been cleared by that doctor, then everything is a green signal. But make sure, guys, you don't reach to a situation where it makes you so difficult, or makes it so difficult for you to get out of that mess. Okay, so keep that in mind. It is of utmost importance to remain fit at all given point of time, right? Because our profession demands our medical fitness to be top notch. And every year, that's where we go through rigorous medicals every single year. And every few years, we do special medicals where more tests are done to ascertain anything happens. And also, if to add on to it, while you're medically fit, let's say, God forbid, something happens like an accident, or where you cannot, continue with the privileges, and you have to get your medical done again, which is as per the regulations, right? Saying that if you have been hospitalized for a certain period, or you've undergone a surgery, you have to do your medicals again, so that, you know, you can continue your privileges. Otherwise it becomes an issue again. So you see, it's a super important topic to keep in mind, that, you know, you cannot mess around with your medicals. Please make sure that anyone who's even planning to start off, or who has aims to become a pilot, first get your medicals done. That's the foremost important thing, so that you don't end up spending a lot of money and later get to know that you are medically unfit. And also keep in mind, if you are converting your licenses, you need to still remain medically fit from that particular state as well. For example, you do from Canada, US, you have to have your medical certificate fit in that country as well, which comes to the point that anywhere in the world you go, your medical fitness is the most important. Remember, if you do not renew your medicals in time, that is, if you miss that window period, that is from the expiry, you have 1 month time before to start your medicals, to finish your medicals. If you have missed it, you need to get an NOC, or no objection certificate, from DGCA to do your medical, which is basically paperwork. You need to email them and they send you the no objection certificate. I hope this video has given you a good information as to what happens when you have been declared medically unfit, what you need to do, temporary unfit, what is your medical assessment, so on and so forth. And also, I hope I have covered all the medical points in this video, and with Aman covering all of them in the last two videos. I hope you've got a clear understanding. we've been getting a lot of questions of lately as to if the medicals are happening class 2, class 1 with COVID. Yes, you got to check out with your doctor. There are certain people doing the medicals. Please check with the nearest doctor and see if you're getting an appointment. I think class 1 initials are getting delayed, but yeah, class 2 renewals, class 1 renewals, initials are happening. So please check up with your doctor. I'm sure they will be the right person to guide you, and also have a look at the DGCA website for any circulars. If you like our video, leave a thumbs up. Do comment down below if you are facing any issues, and also get in touch on our Instagram handles if you need any help, any advice from this industry. We'll be glad to help you out. I hope you guys are doing good. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay fit, and don't forget to subscribe if you've come so far. Share it with your friends, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.